Now let's look at actually having to graph a piecewise function given a formula. You can see for this piecewise function, we're given two pieces. One piece for x values that are less than negative 1, and another piece for x values that are greater than or equal to negative 1. I'm going to use two different colors so that you can see the two different pieces graphed. But remember, this is all the same function. So what I always tell students to do is to create a table of values. Let's do it for x plus 1 first. This asked us to do it for the domain for x values that are strictly less than negative 1. We're still going to figure out what that value is on that function at negative 1 because of the fact that we need to have an open circle there. When you're creating these tables of values, always use these endpoints in your intervals so that you know where you're going to start the function and end the function, whether it's an open or a closed circle. Now find a couple other points to find. So for x values that are less than negative 1, some other examples would be x is negative 2 and x is negative 3. And now we'll plug those into our formula. Negative 1 plus 1 is 0. Negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. And negative 3 plus 1 is negative 2. Now I can graph this function. So at x is negative 1, we're going to have an open circle because this is strictly less than. So negative 1 is at 0, the y value of 0. Negative 2 is at a y value of negative 1. And negative 3 we found was at negative 2. So now I have enough points that I can graph this. We'll put an arrow at the end because this showed that this was for all x values less than negative 1. We'll do the same thing for the second piece. Let's start at the endpoints. You always want to start at the endpoints that they've given you for the inequalities for your pieces. And then find values that are also in that interval. So x values that are bigger than or equal to negative 1 would be 0, 1, and I'll do one more, I'll try 2. So when I plug those in, I get negative 1 squared minus 2, which is negative 1. When I plug 0 in, I get 0 squared minus 2, which is negative 2. When I plug 1 in, I get 1 squared minus 2, which is negative 1. And when I plug 2 in, I get 2 squared minus 2, which is 2. So now I have these points that I can graph. Now at negative 1, I will have a solid circle because I can actually equal it. So negative 1 starts down here with a solid circle. At 0, I'm down at negative 2. At 1, I'm at negative 1. And at 2, I'm at 2. And this is a parabola. It's going to go on forever in that direction because this is for all x values bigger than or equal to negative 1. So again, separate out each piece, do a table of values for each separate piece, and make sure you always are including those endpoints, even if it's going to be an open circle there. Let's try this again. If you want to see if you've learned it, you can always pause this video, try to work this out on your own, and then unpause it to watch me work through it. All right, we'll do this piece in green. So we'll let x and y equal 2x minus 1. So this is for x values that are larger than 2. So again, we'll start at 2 because we have to have an open circle there. And then I'll choose values that are larger than it, like 3 and 4. So when I plug those in, I get 2 times 2 minus 1, which is 3. When I plug 3 in, I get 2 times 3 minus 1, which is 5. And when I plug 4 in, I get 2 times 4 minus 1, which is 7. When I go to graph this, I'll have an open circle at x equals 2. So that point was 2, 3. Then I had a point at 3, 5. And then a point at 4, 7. And this goes on forever in that direction. And now we'll do a table of values for the second part. Okay, so this is for x values that are less than or equal to 2. So again, we'll start at 2, and then we'll just choose some values that are less than it, like 1 and 0. 2 minus 2 is 0. 1 minus 2 minus 1 is 1. And 2 minus 0 is 2. Now when I go to graph this one, I'll have a solid circle at less than or equal to. So let's start at 2, 0, 1, 1, and 0, 2. So this is the line that goes up in this direction forever. Let's do one more example together. This piecewise defined function actually has three pieces to it. Okay, let's look at the first piece. And again, if you feel like you think you may have gotten this, I really recommend stopping the video, trying to work this out on your video worksheet by yourself, and then restarting the video again to make sure you've done it right. And if you haven't done it right, you can see where you made your mistakes. The best way to learn math is by doing it. If you just sit and watch someone do it, you're not going to learn it, but you really need to try it and do it yourself. Okay, so let's start with this first piece, 3 minus x, and that's for x values that are less than 0. So again, I'll start at 0. You always want to start at those endpoints. And other values that are less than 0 are like negative 1 and negative 2. So when I plug 0 in, 3 minus 0 is 3. 3 minus a negative 1 is 4. Oops. Yep. And then 3 minus a negative 2 is 5. So when I graph this, there will be an open circle at x equals 0 because we cannot equal it. So when x was 0, your y was 3. At negative 1, we were at 4. And then at negative 2, we were at 5. And then we had the second piece, which says if x equals 0, your y is 2. So that's just going to be a point when x is 0, y is 2. And then for the last piece, we're using x squared for x being greater than or equal to 0. So some values of x that are larger than 0, again, we're going to start at 0, even though we're only greater than 0, just because we need an open circle there. We'll do 1 and 2. So 0 squared is 0, 1 squared is 1, and 2 squared is 4. When I go to graph these, 0, 0, and we'll do an open circle there since we can't equal it. 1, 1, and then 2, 4. And that's a parabola. So there is how to graph these types of piecewise defined functions. If you want some more practice graphing them or to watch some more examples of them, here's a great website video to go to.